Let's go through now each of these steps and talk about ways that you can differentiate yourself. In the very beginning, when you come in, is a chance for you to connect quickly with the interviewer. And that's where being friendly is important and also having warmth. I have to emphasize warmth because sometimes students or people taking cases can get very transactional. They can think, hey, if I do a good job on the case, you have to give me an offer. And that's not the case at all. The person has to see that you can do well on the case, but also really like you and think you're a great fit for their company. And that warmth factor is critical because in order to do well in your new job, you're going to have to get data from either internal clients or external clients if you're at a consulting firm or some strategy group. And getting data really requires you to connect to people quickly. So don't forget to show interest in your interviewer, interest in the business and the work at hand, which is the case. And then I have to emphasize being answer first. Being answer first is not the thinking answer first, like having a hypothesis, but in this case, it's all about communication. Communication where you can actually explain to the interviewer very succinctly what you want to focus on. So getting to the point quickly will speed up your case and also make it very easy for the interviewer to interact with you. I'm sorry if you hear a lot of bells going on right now. I don't know if you can hear them. I'm in London at a school working here, and there's a lot of noise outside my room here. So let's move on now to number 2 and 3. And by the way, I want to remind you that this is a great chance for you to ask questions. We're going to go through a lot of material quickly, so if something triggers a thought in your mind, go ahead and type it in the chat, and I'll cover it at the end. Now, as we get into the start of the case, we want to show breadth and depth of thinking. This is where the interviewer can say to you, what else, really pushing on your breadth, and also push on the depth. You know, can you be more specific or ask you to get into some kind of detail? But the big thing I want to emphasize here to show differentiation is to show common sense. You know, sometimes candidates will say, oh, I want the competitor data, which makes sense in class when you have an appendix to look at or some information to go through. But in real life, the competitor has the competitor data and is not really keen on giving you that information. So sometimes the interviewer can feel like your thoughts don't make a lot of sense. One way you can work on building those skills of having common sense is oftentimes giving yourself constraints. Pretend that you only had 1 week to get the assignment done, whatever the problem is. What data could you get really easily and what data would be more difficult? But showing when you structure why something is a priority or what common sense you have would be really important. Let's move down to now anticipate. And I want to talk about our hands. During the case, your left hand, in a sense, is the structure, and that's the section that we've covered already with putting number 2 and 3 down, which is basically structuring and interacting with the interviewer. In number 3, you'll put down your plan or approach, and in a sense, you'll have a left-hand sheet of paper that you'll be showing the interviewer how you think about this. That leads to the next part of the case, which is eventually you're going to get a right-hand sheet. This is where the data is going to come to you either in the form of a slide or a handout, or the interviewer is going to read you a bunch of data, which we call a data dump. Now, where we're going with this is our left hand, our structure, and our right hand, our analysis, need to come together and integrate. So when you're in the case, think about, as I'm doing my left hand work, my structure, my plan, my approach, can I get my brain into the kind of data that I want? And that's where we go down to the data pool and talk about anticipation. Thinking ahead to the data you need is a great way to differentiate yourself. It's also very easy. Usually by the time you're finished structuring out your plan, you know very clearly the kind of case you have. When the interviewer introduces it, it's very hard to know because there might be curveballs. But after you put your structure together and talk to the interviewer about it, you typically know that a market entry or is it a merger between two companies, or maybe it's profitability with one little twist that the interviewer is concerned about. You should be able to anticipate the kind of data you'll get. With market entry, I'd want to know the amount of share I would get in that new market. I'd want to know price points and what the competitors are doing specifically. Or if I'm dealing with profitability, of course, I'd want to know the drivers of profit. And now it's getting pretty easy to predict what I'll probably get in the analysis section. If it's profitability, they might give me data on what our numbers were before and what's led to the change or the shift, or maybe a graph showing the profit drop off over a period of time. If I'm doing market entry, I probably could get data on other competitors and their share in those new markets and what their offerings are about. Getting my brain into that future state, like what I should get, is one way to differentiate yourself and probably the most important. The transition from the structure to the data is where a lot of people waste a lot of time. They don't think ahead, and when they get the analysis, they're not really anticipating. Another thing you can do to differentiate yourself in the data pool is to dive in. Show an eagerness to get into that area. Sometimes when you're in the structuring zone, the interviewer will unexpectedly say, hey, I've got data for you, and that's called getting thrown into the data pool. But diving in is when you are asking for the data and pushing in that direction. And as you get better, that should be your typical mode. Lastly, estimating is another great way to differentiate yourself. Sometimes when people get data, they do what I call chin down, which means they go right into the data and doing analysis, and they miss the opportunity to discuss it. Discussing it, estimating, doing mental math is a great way to differentiate yourself. Because oftentimes, if the interviewer hears that you've got a number that's pretty close to what they're talking about, they don't require you to do the detailed math, and you've avoided not only a risky situation where you can make mistakes, but you also have avoided wasting time.